Hi friends, in this tutorial we'll see how to analyze Spring Boot logs using the ELK stack. So ELK stands for Elasticsearch, Logstash and Kibana. So we'll see what are these technologies and how to use them for analyzing the Spring Boot logs. For this I'll be taking reference of my website javainews.com. So go to Spring Boot section. The example that we are going to see today is Spring Boot microservices plus ELK stack hello world example. I'll be sharing this URL along with the YouTube video. So when running microservices along with the ELK stack, this is the architecture that we follow. So there will be multiple microservices running and they generate logs. These logs, they are read by the Logstash and they are indexed to a central Elasticsearch server. And from there, Kibana is used, which provides the UI for the Elasticsearch results. So let us have a look at the ELK stack in detail. So as told previously, the ELK stack, it consists of three open source products: Elasticsearch, Logstash and Kibana, and all these products are provided by Elastic itself. Elasticsearch is a NoSQL database that is based on the Lucene search engine. So it will be the central repository where we'll be storing our logs. Logstash is a log pipeline tool that accepts inputs from various sources, executes different transformations and exports the data to various targets. So in our case, what it will be doing is it will be accepting input from the log files. It will be performing some transformations and then exporting it to the Elasticsearch. Kibana is a visualization UI layer that works on top of Elasticsearch. So the results that are returned from Elasticsearch, they are represented in a better way in Kibana, like various graphs and pie charts. They can be easily created using Kibana. So these three projects, they are used together for log analysis in various environments. So Logstash, it collects and passes the logs. Elasticsearch indexes and stores this information, while Kibana, it provides a UI layer that provides actionable insights. So in which scenarios are we going to use the ELK stack? If the microservices that we are using, if they produce small logs, then obviously they can be manually analyzed by a person and we can get whatever the results or the insights that we want. But suppose if these logs, they are very large, and also suppose if multiple applications are running and therefore there will be quite a few logs. So it is just not possible to analyze these logs manually. So we'll have to use these frameworks. So we use ELK to analyze the logs more efficiently, and also using more complex search criteria, it provides log aggregation and efficient searching. So let's begin with the implementation part. First we'll have to download the ELK stack. So first we'll be downloading Elasticsearch. So download the latest version of Elasticsearch from this URL here. So here you will have to click on this download Windows. I am using a Windows machine. You can download whichever operating system you are using. Next, unzip the download that you have just downloaded and go to the Elasticsearch bin folder. Here you will have to do elasticsearch.bat, and this will start your Elasticsearch. If you'll go to localhost 9200, you'll see that the Elasticsearch, it has started. Next we'll be downloading and configuring Kibana. So open this Kibana downloads. So here again I'll be downloading Kibana for Windows. Unzip this download once it is done. So once you have downloaded the Kibana installation, we'll have to make some changes to Kibana config before starting it. So go to kibana.yaml file. And here you will have to uncomment this elasticsearch.url. So we want this elasticsearch.url, it should point to the localhost 9200 on which we have started our Elasticsearch. Now we can start the Kibana. So for this we'll have to go to the bin folder. So this will start Kibana. So once Kibana has started, you can go to this port localhost 5601 on which Kibana starts by default. So this is the Kibana UI using which we will be analyzing the Elasticsearch results. Finally, we'll be downloading Logstash. So yeah, I'll be downloading the zip version. For now, just unzip whatever the Logstash installation that we have downloaded. We'll have to make some configuration changes for Logstash. We'll be making it later on after we understand the Spring Boot application and the type of log files that we are going to generate. So based on the log files, we'll be making some changes to the log stash configuration, which we'll see later on. Next, let us create the Spring Boot microservice whose logs we are going to analyze. So go to Eclipse and create a new Maven project. Create a simple project. Group ID, put it as gom.java in use. Artifact ID, I'll be giving it as boot-elk. Next, we'll be adding the required dependencies. So since we are creating a simple web project where we are going to expose an API, so the only dependency that we'll be needing will be the Spring Boot starter web dependency. No other dependency will be required. So just copy these dependencies. Next, we'll be creating the Spring Boot Bootstrap class. So here we'll be using the Spring Boot application annotation. This class is needed to start the Spring Boot application. So create this class. The package will be com.java in use. And the application name will be Spring Boot Hello World application. Next, we'll be defining a REST API. So here we are going to define two APIs. So one will be having the mapping slash ELK. So whenever this API is called, it will just log the statement welcome to Java in use and the date to the log file. Similarly, we'll be having another API with the mapping slash exception. So whenever this API is called, we'll be throwing an exception with the message exception has occurred, and this stack trace we are going to store it in the logs. So the logs that we are going to create, it will be in the location CELK Spring Boot ELK log. So this will have to specify in the application.properties. So the logs will be containing two statements for us. One will be welcome to in Java news along with the date, and the other will be exception. And here we are configuring where the logs are to be created. So let us first create this class. So create this class. Copy the contents. Finally, for this application, in the application.properties, we'll be specifying the log location that we want it to be created. So create a file application.properties. And here copy the logging.file location. So finally, we'll be configuring the logstash pipeline. So previously we had downloaded the logstash installation. So logstash pipeline, it consists of three parts: the input, the filters, and the output. So the input, we specify from where we are going to read the logs. So currently we are going to read the logs from the log file, so we'll be specifying this path here, CELK Spring Boot ELK.log, in this input section. Also, in this input section, we specify whether we have to read the lines of the logs line by line or whether we have to read it as a block. Now, since we have the stack trace also in the logs, which is multiple line of codes, so we'll be specifying multi-line property in case of input. Next, we have the filters here. So in filters, we modify or we filter out whatever are the log lines that are to be indexed to the Elasticsearch. So in case of in filters, what we are going to do is, in case of stack trace, we are going to add an additional tag which will specify that this is the stack trace of the exception. We'll see how to do this. And finally, we have the output part. So in output, we specify where we have to index the log files that we have. So we are going to index it to Elasticsearch. Also, in the output section, we'll be printing the output to the console for debugging purposes. So let us configure the logstash pipeline. So in the logstash bin folder, we'll be creating this logstash.conf. And here, as seen previously, first we have the input. So here we specify that from where the logs are to be read. And also here we are specifying the multi-line property. Next, we have the filter. So here what we are doing is that if the log message it contains the word at, then what we do is we are adding a tag stack trace to that message. And finally, in the output, what we are doing is we are sending the log events to Elasticsearch. Also, using this codec Ruby debug, we are printing the output that is the pass log events also to the console. So let's create this file. So go to the logstash bin folder and here create a document. So in this I'll be pasting this logstash.conf data. I'll be saving this file as logstash.conf. Next we'll be starting logstash. So for this is the command that we'll be using. So here go to the bin folder and using this command we'll be starting logstash. So logstash has started. Next we'll be starting the Spring Boot application. So currently in the CELK folder, once we start the Spring Boot application, this log file it will get generated. So here this is the log file that the application it has started. Let us now go to localhost 8080/ELK. So this will generate some more logs for us. So I'll be hitting this URL multiple times. So if we'll go and see in the logs now, I think it doesn't refresh, so I'll just start it again. So here we can see that the logs they are getting correctly appended here to the logs. Next let us generate some exception logs. So for this the URL was exception. So this is the stack trace that should have got appended to the logs. So we'll have to close this again. So here these exception logs they are also getting appended correctly. So I'll just hit these multiple times. The logstash application that we started, it was continuously polling the Spring Boot elk.log file. So if we go to the logstash window, here we'll see that it is indexing the logs that we have generated to Elasticsearch. Here we can see that in the console, since we are printing the what is to be indexed to Elasticsearch to console, so here we can see that. Now open Postman and go to the URL http://localhost/9200 on which our Elasticsearch is running and underscore cat indices ?v. So what this shows is what all are the indices that are created. So by default logstash it will be creating an index logstash hyphen today's date. So this is the index that was created when we when logstash indexed the data to Elasticsearch. So let us see what data has been indexed to this index. So for this the URL is logstash, the name of the index underscore search. So if we do search here, we'll see that these are the logs that have been indexed to Elasticsearch. Also if we search, so here we have added the stack trace tag in the filter for some of the exceptions. So our logstash and Elasticsearch, they are working well. Next we'll see how this data can be seen in Kibana. To see this data for the logstash index that was just created, we'll need to create an index pattern in Kibana. So this is the index pattern that we'll have to give. So go to Kibana, go to the management, here go to index patterns, create index pattern. The index pattern name that we'll be giving is logstash star. So it will automatically show which all logstash indexes of this type are there. Click on next. You select the time filter field name and do a create index pattern. So our index has been created. Next go to the discover section. So here we can see that we are able to see the Elasticsearch results in Kibana. We'll be looking in other examples in more details of how we can use Kibana to get more insights into this log data, but this was just a hello world example. I hope you have understood how to integrate the Spring Boot logs for analysis with the ELK stack. The source code, if you want to download, you can download it from here. Thank you.